The report from the Committee on Climate Change is really a response to the government's request for advice on its long-term emissions targets. What it's actually saying is that if the government really wants to meet its, you know, commitments to climate change, then it needs to set a target of zero carbon emissions by 2050. I think what's clear is that offshore wind is not just going to be part of the energy mix going forward, but it's actually going to form the backbone of a modern, smart, resilient, clean, affordable energy system. And I guess you have to see that as a massive opportunity for the whole industry, opportunity for investment in infrastructure, opportunity for growth in supply chain, opportunity to grow a large, skilled workforce. So, you know, the report is really significant for us in the offshore wind sector. We're going to see even more growth and more opportunity for the UK supply chain. You're going to see more investment in infrastructure. You're going to see more investment in innovation, opportunities for businesses up and down the coastline of this country. The types of communities that really need that investment the most really benefiting. And along the way, you're going to see tens of thousands of new, high qualified, highly skilled jobs being created. I think it's clear that offshore wind is going to be the backbone of our electricity system going forward. But what we shouldn't do is overlook the really important contribution that other forms of clean energy generation can provide. So things like onshore wind and solar really have a massive role to play as well. It's not just about creating clean, green, low-cost electricity, but also in their own right, creating a lot of opportunities for supply chain growth and investment in local communities. It's a really exciting time to be working in the energy sector because apart from cleaning up the generation portfolio, we're also looking at a complete change in other parts of the energy system. So we're now looking at how do we electrify transport, how do we electrify heat, how are we going to store all of this clean green electricity that we produce. So all of that means a lot of investment and all of that means a lot of opportunity. So it doesn't matter what part of the energy sector you're in, I really can't imagine a more fascinating time to be working in the energy sector than right now.